Jeff, you've covered presidential campaigns going all the way back to 2000, Bush Gore, and you've covered every transition that has come about as a result. How do you see the first 100 days of the Biden administration unfolding?
Look, I think it is going to be dominated by really two things, the economic recession and the pandemic. And I think of farmers, I think of food. I mean, there is a hunger crisis in this country. And I'm not sure that that is addressed enough in Washington. That shouldn't be partisan. People waiting in a food line for 3 hours, you know, I bet it's pretty much a mix of Democrats and Republicans. I mean, this is not just a one-party issue.
You could disagree with some of the folks that that Joe Biden is going to appoint, but certainly they do know how government works. A lot of those folks that he's named, we have worked with in one form or another over the years in agriculture, and I think we will have some good opportunities. Climate is a real opportunity for us if we do it right. Trade, obviously, you know, we can export a lot more corn from the United States.
I was in the room in Wilmington, Delaware, the other week when Joe Biden was announcing his new national security foreign policy team, and the word China wasn't raised. That, of course, is front and center in every trade discussion. So I think we'll have to hear more from President-elect Biden on what he's going to do with China and trade policies. But I still remember every time we talk about trade, I still remember a bumper sticker on a pickup truck that was always at the grain elevator in our nearby town. This was during the 80s farm crisis. It said trade, not aid. And I remember my dad always used to talk about, we just want a fair shot. But I think that people want more opportunity to do more trade on the markets.